Duncan is an angry yellow tank engine that works on the Scarlowy Railway. He likes to complain and is generally an unpleasant fellow. He brings passengers up and down the Scarlowy Railway from the quarries to the stations. This is some humbug. One day, he was having a conversation with Scarlowy.
Is it just me or is the workload getting more and more plentiful? Honestly, it feels like the thing controller is trying to kill us.
I am here getting worked off my wheels and I don't even get some sort of award for it.
Honestly, I have to sit in this disgusting shit, work at a quarry and shunt trucks and workmen up and down the line. It's disgraceful.
Oh, Duncan, stop complaining.
Honestly,
it feels like you're just complaining for fun.
You have a good life here, Duncan, and I know you cannot realize that, but you need to, my friend. Alright, your arguments are invalid. You need to take in consideration the people around you. Do you understand me? You don't make your arguments valid, you just like to complain for no reason.
I beg your pardon.
My complaints are totally valid.
And yes, the thin controller is trying to work me off my wheels.
Scarlowy, are you listening to me?
No, I need to go take a passenger train. Goodbye, Duncan.
Huh, what a prat.
And soon Duncan would follow suit, as he had to leave as well. But indeed, his complaints were not valid whatsoever. Every day he would complain to everything and everyone about everything and everyone. Doesn't matter where he were, he would always complain. It was really, really annoying. Oh, and you should not catch him pulling trucks.
Oh, trucks.
Everyone was getting tired of listening to his complaining. It's difficult to listen to him just yabbering off about nothing. It didn't matter if his complaints were valid or not. Don't really know what an invalid complaint would look like, honestly, but he would always find something to complain about, and always find someone to complain to. All the time, everyone had to endure his suffering.
One day, Duncan was in the shed when he met a cow named Bessie. Bessie Tinkerbells the Third.
Moo. Moo.
You want me to take the passengers up to the quarry, and then the Croven's Gate?
Moo.
How do I know I can listen to you? You're just a cow!
Moo.
Screw this. I'm out of here. Fine, I'll go take your passengers. Have to sit here and listen to livestock.
Moo.
Later, Duncan was coupled up to his train of workmen. However, it was a rather long train filled with a lot of workmen. And the coaches weren't exactly new.
Of course I have to do these stupid jobs.
The task was difficult.
Come on! Move it, stupid coaches! Move it! Move it, stupid!
Come on! Come on!
Don't pull us that hard!
Come on while reaching a hill now.
And they did. It was a mildly steep hill, but with that much gradient, anything was difficult to pull. Especially old coaches.
Come on!
I think my coupler feels weird.
Eventually, Duncan started to stall up the hill. It was really, really difficult.
Come on!
Wait a minute, I think my coupler fit is a little weird. Whatever that noise was. But then, the coupler snapped.
No! Coaches! Come back!
Well, what are you doing? After them, old boy!
You're right, I've gotta go!
Come on! Get back here!
What?
Duncan! What are you doing?
Help us, please. We don't want to die. Come on. I've got you.
That's it, Duncan. We're gaining on them.
I sure hope so.
Duncan's wheels were whirring and his pistons pounding harder than ever before. I'm gonna catch those coaches if it's the last thing I ever do.
Come on! I'm almost there!
Almost there. Almost there.
Gotcha!
Haha!
Yes! Duncan, slow us down, please! Haha! I've got them! Yes!
Thank you, Duncan. And with that, Duncan rolled all the way to the quarry, and then back down to Croven's Gate. There, he would meet Thomas, who was delivering passengers with Annie Little. Hello, Duncan. I heard about your shebang at the hill. That was scary. I can imagine. But it's good that you're okay, and it's also good that the coaches are okay. You're a really brave engine. I didn't know you had that in you. Oh, it was nothing really. I try my best, you know, Thomas. But thank you. Thank you very, very much. I do appreciate it. And with that, Duncan rolled back to the sheds.
Hello there, everyone. What are you all doing here? Why all so smiley? We heard about what you did at the quarry. With those men and the coaches. We're very proud of you, Duncan.
Good job, Duncan. I really think that you have proved yourself today.
I agree. Definitely.
I think Duncan deserves a round of
applause.
I
agree. Definitely.
3 cheers for Duncan. Hip hip
hooray! Hooray!
Hip hip hooray!
Hooray!
Hip hip
hooray!
Hooray!
Good job, Duncan.
I appreciate
good job,
you,
Duncan.
I believed in you all along.
I think you've done a good job, Duncan.
Good job, Duncan. What would we have ever done without you?
Did you know I was supposed to be non-binary?
Duncan was very happy for the applause that he was receiving. He was also very proud of himself for what he had done that day.
A true redemption for Duncan.
Aw, thanks, guys. You shouldn't have.
Nowadays, Duncan is a cheery guy. He's still grumpy every now and then, but that's just because that's the type of engine that he is. He can't help it. And of course, whenever he complains, they don't take it hardly. And neither does Duncan. That is a very broken crate. Oh, that's a lot of Duncans. Holy crap. This just goes to show that it does not take a lot to turn your life around and become a better person. Now that's a good moral.